Hey, this is Frank.
This is Ray from My Chemical Romance, and you're watching the Kerrang! Video Podcast.
It's do you have to repeat that?
No.
Okay, good. It's flattering, but at the same time, you know, it's I think our kids kind of don't give themselves enough credit, you know. A lot of, they say that a lot, but I think the truth of the matter is, you know, we maybe have written a song that helped them get through a hard time. Maybe it was, you know, the soundtrack to their, you know, their success, basically, because they're the ones that they're their own hero, basically. They've saved their own lives. It's nothing that we're doing, you know, but we've, you know, I'm happy that we've inspired them, but, you know, they need to give themselves more credit.
I definitely feel the same way. You know, we might, you know, give them a little push for the song, but it's definitely them finding the strength within themselves. So, that's how we feel about it. It's kind of interesting. I think for this record, I feel like we were more influenced by film and anime, you know, more than music. this one was interesting. I think for us, I think the songs that we were writing were really influencing the sound, you know. And I think we each take a little bit from things that we enjoyed when we were younger, things that we grew up with. For us, though, this record, there wasn't, you know, one thing that we could kind of draw upon. You know, Black Parade definitely was drawing upon those bands because it was a kind of a big, grand, epic, you know, rock record. This one, you know, the influences are so varied. I feel like, for me, I mean, my biggest influences on this record was everybody else in the band, because we were all really coming up with new things and kind of inspiring each other to try different things.
He's doing great, man. It was rad getting to play with him after, touring with him and being friends from a distance for a long time, you know. Our band and his old band, The Bled, toured a lot. Early on in our careers, and he was, you know, always such a rad dude. Like, we got along. There's this weird connection. Like, it almost seemed like he was like from Jersey, the way he acts and the way he was brought up. But it's cool, man. He's a really hard hitter. He's a great musician and a really good friend. So it's pretty fun.
Let's play from the heart. Play like you mean it. You know, love what you're doing. And make music with your friends.
It sounds cliche, but, like, you know, every day, like, every week, there's, like, a new thing that we get to accomplish that, like, we only dreamed about as being kids. Like, I mean, the fact that we left our basement with this band is a dream come true, you know? I mean, we never expected to be doing the things that we're doing. And, there's milestones, like, every month. So, I'm just...
Just
keep making them. Yeah. It's crazy, you know? Ray Toro.
Yeah.
Because he's really good at video games.
You know, Mikey, if it were a first-person shooter, I'd pick Mikey. Because he kills on Battlefield and Call of Duty. So, I think if we were gunning down people with ray guns, it'd be Mikey to play.
To narrow it down to one song to put into a time capsule, I don't know. I mean, I think, you know, Welcome to the Black Parade, I think, is one of those songs that was like climbing a mountain.
Yeah.
You know, and once we finally did, I don't think that song could possibly have come out any better. Like, I don't think anybody could have done a better job with that song. We clawed and fought and finally accomplished that song. It really was.
Little bits of that song have been around, you know, before we recorded it, for probably 5 or 6 years. So that's definitely a good representation of the band, I think, and kind of the ambition that the band has.
That was nerve-wracking, man. That's like a completely different world than we're used to. I don't know how you can get used to that, because it sounds horrible from where you are, you know what I mean? Like, there's this slap back of, like, you know, you're dealing with not only, like, you know, just trying to play well and sing well, but also, like, this echo, and then, you know, you can't hear anybody else, and it's like it's a whole different kind of it's a whole different ball game, literally.
being fans, yeah. Frankie and Mikey are huge football fans.
Yeah, we just like watching it. So that was the plus too. I mean, I was like, it was my birthday, and I got to watch a football game, and I was like, yeah, that's pretty cool.
Who's your team?
Steelers and Giants. Right. Yeah, Mikey's Jets all the way, but he likes the Giants too, so that's why you were cool.
I think probably Kids from Yesterday, we've been closing the set with it. Planetary though has been right now they're kind of neck and neck for me. You know, they're two different energies. You know, Planetary is just like full bore, you know, high energy all the time, and then Kids from Yesterday is a little bit more subdued, but I think it's a really meaningful and moving song. And also the way we've been ending the sets with it, I think it's just like Frankie kind of came up with the idea of how to leave the stage, and it's just a very classy way for us to end the set. So
that's like a treat for us at the end.
Yeah,
you know?
It's probably my favorite part of that song is when you think the song's over and then it just comes back for more. I love that. So